Come on up. I'm getting blind in my old age. I can't see way back there. Good man. Good man. Say you wanna put your hat on me tonight. I'm trying to take a vacation while I'm right here in this moment. Come on up. I have all this room up here. I can actually see in the first three or four rows. You can leave your work. Keep coming. Keep coming. Yeah, buddy. Come on. Keep front row wants to grow. Back row doesn't know. Front row wants to grow. That's what I'm talking about. Front row wants to grow. I ain't scared. Okay. We're gonna go on vacation one more time.
Yeah, just a little bit. Where are we going now?
To an island. Yes. What are you bringing? You're going to an island. What are you bringing?
How much can I bring?
A what?
How much can I bring?
Just one item. What are you bringing?
A fire starter.
A fire starter. You're going to an island. You're bringing a fire starter and what? Uh-oh, it's like that. I know those islands. So, I'm going to an island, I'm bringing a fire starter, my bear skin, and what?
Fishing pole.
Fishing pole. I'm going to an island, I'm bringing what? A fire starter, bear skin, a fishing pole, and a woman. I'm going to an island, I'm bringing what? What's it start with? Fire starter. Bear skin. Fishing pole. A woman. A cooler full of beer. This is why we do this. All right, you guys ready to rock and roll? Good afternoon, everyone. How is everybody? You enjoying your time? Huh? We be happy. Fantastic. I'm Jennifer Bagley, CEO of SCI Web Group. I'm happy to be here. I have some of my colleagues with me. I have Miss Kathy Marshall back right. And she is head of training and customer service. Miss Kim, who's an account executive on our project and marketing team. And Michael Hicklin, my husband, and our chief operating officer. And he's who gets me here on time. He has a video in the back of the room, so feel free to turn around and say hi here and there. After the presentation, if you guys have an interest in leaving a quick video about what you thought or learned today, meet Mike in the back of the room. Of course, we'll brand you, get your website out there, and that's what we do. We're a marketing company. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about how to leverage digital. I tell everybody before they come to this workshop to take some aspirin in advance because this stuff can give you a headache. I get it. But hopefully, we'll make it fun. How many of you are interested in growing? How many would you consider yourself, in a nutshell, you're an entrepreneur? Raise your hand. Okay. So as an entrepreneur, at one point, you sat down with your spouse. And there was a rationale, a reason for becoming an entrepreneur. You wanted three things, more of three things. What was it?
Time, money, and
free. I don't need to put this slide up here, and I can get the same answer from any business owner anywhere in the nation and abroad. It's why we do this. And does your spouse at this point think that you told the truth? Do you feel like you have more time, money, and freedom? I get it. I'm an entrepreneur. So I've been through the same thing from scratch. Left corporate, it's the same thing. That transition is difficult. The challenge is that we often forget why we did this. Why we sunk every ounce of time and energy and blood and sweat and tears and capital and credit card debt and whatever else we dropped into this business that our employees will never understand to start this company, and at some point we forget the reason behind it. How many of you would love to be able to take 3 weeks, 4 weeks vacation in the middle of summer and not worry? How many wives are here and your husbands told you the same vacation? It's not. It's a lie. So when you know, when you stick to your root of why you become an entrepreneur, you make different decisions. But we get into the mode of working and business and fires and operations and resources, dealing with people and dealing with clients and dealing with every fire that comes to the table, instead of designing a business based on a system to free ourselves from the labor that comes with being an entrepreneur. It has to be a system. It has to be systemic. And it's hard because there's a lot of people that are coaching you guys that have never started a company, giving you input on what you should do, how you should spend, what you should buy, and everything else. And they have not done it themselves. And it's hard to take all that advice and start picking through it to determine what makes sense for my business. So, in order to sell anything, you guys need a buyer. That's the bottom line. Regardless of the product, regardless of the bells and whistles, regardless of anything, you need people who are interested in purchasing your products and services. And in order to create more time, money, and freedom, you need effective operational strategies that reduce redundancies, duplicate processes, inefficiencies that exasperate your time, that steal your minutes from you. How many of you are owners? We got to get it to where you only do the things that only you can do. We have to get it there. So I don't want you to work all the time. I want you to be able to plan that goal a month. The whole point of becoming an entrepreneur is you can take 10 vacations if you want, if the infrastructure is in place to do so. The only caveat is you have one wild card. What's your one wild card? People. That's the tough part. Okay? In order to maximize results. So, this is my son. This is my family. We all owe Brad bikes, these electric bikes, so we bike ride. We're only home. My husband and I, so we have two RVs. We have one here, and we have one in California. And we live in Seattle on a houseboat, but we're only there for 3 months a year in the summers when you guys are busy and leave us all alone. We don't have to travel the rest of the United States. But freedom is important. Every decision, even in my own business, is always about how do we design this to be free from it. not to force ourselves to be in it forever. But in order to do that, we have to do the right things in the right order at the right time. And I cannot express how critical that is. The right things done in the wrong order produce the wrong results. Or you get a limited return for whatever your intention was. If it was to save time, if it was to make more money, whatever your intention was, you're gonna get a small percentage of the effort. Just to wrap that into perspective. This is a program called the 12-Step Roadmap to Achieve Accelerated Results. It's dynamic. So as consumers' habits change, as technology changes, as Google's requirements change, it has to change too. It's 12 steps, 12 stages. Let me show you an example of doing something in the wrong order. Okay, wrong time. If I have a website built by a triple F, maybe you want to guess what a triple F is. I'll start with friends. Family. What's next? Free. Fools. Felons. Keep going. Whatever. Okay? And I go spend money on search engine optimization to get my website to the number one ranking on Google. And I get there. When somebody goes to the site, if it's not designed professionally, if it doesn't have all the right bells and whistles, whether they're looking on an Android or an Apple or a tablet or a PC, or if they're talking to Amazon Alexa and displaying it on their screen on a projector, however people search, if that's done wrong, your investment in SEO, you lose. If I spend money on a great website, and I spend money on SEO, and I start on social media, that's free, and I start driving people to the website, driving people to search for my company brand, if my reviews look bad, you lose. So let me ask you this. You guys, forget about everything I just said for just a second. You guys are consumers. How many of you are moms? Dads? Husbands? Wives? Wannabes? Just kidding. When you need something, what do? Say it loud.
Google
it. Raise your hand if you Google it. Look around. Everyone turn around, look. Everyone keep your hand up. That means keep your hand up and look around. I want you to get the stats. Okay? You Google it. The whole room raise their hands. When you Google it, let me show you something. How many of you click on, I'm not going to pull it up. How many of you click on the ads at the top? Look around. Everybody turn and look, because I know you guys buy this stuff. I don't have anybody raise their hands. How many of you click on the maps? On the map search in Google. When the map comes up? Yes, 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 yes. Great. How many of you click on the first page results? There's 10 on the first page. Okay. How many of you go to the second page? I got it sometimes. And I got it never. Quite contrasting. Okay? Here's the beauty of this. Marketing your business is this simple. What do you want to sell? Where do you want to sell it? Are you an option when and where people are looking? And do you look good when they get there? That's it. I love being a speaker. I probably spoke to 200, 300,000 people last year in almost every state. I think we missed 5 states last year. And I get to ask every audience, doesn't matter if you're in Dubuque, Iowa, or Poughkeepsie, New York, or you're in Texas, in Killeen, or El Paso, it doesn't matter where you're at, every audience says the same thing. And I've been asking these questions for decades. Didn't used to be the same answers. Every year, it tweaks a little bit. Last year when I asked the same answer, I always had one or two people in the back that said, I click on pay-per-click ads, and I'm like, well, what were you looking for? I don't know. Okay. This year, I don't have that. Now, I know people do click on pay-per-click ads. It's just not the kind of people in this room.
where you're checking out your competitors at. If you start your business without a database, a CRM, a contact relationship management system, the ability to schedule appointments, later on when you're ready to start tackling that database, you're not going to be able to. Because maybe the only place you kept your data was in QuickBooks and all you have is customer data. But you had thousands of leads that came to you over the years that you could be remarketing to. You could easily, with one email, it doesn't matter if you send it to 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, or one, it's the same investment of time and resources. Okay? Does that make sense as far as time and order, sequence? If any one of those, let me ask, okay, so let's say you get on the first page of Google and you find an option, a company. Website doesn't really look great. What do you guys do? Next, okay. Let's say the website does look good. You can tell who they are, what they do, where they do it, how to reach them, what other people think about them. Looks good. What are you gonna go look for next once you identify a company, before you hire them?
Reviews.
Raise your hand if it's reviews, look around. Humans are easy. And the advertising people who are born and raised in advertising and go to school for advertising and that's what they've done, they are really hard to retrain. They apply for jobs at our company all day, every day. And I listen to their, you gotta hit them 7 times. I've heard it. What do you guys do when you go to the mailbox? What's your first stop?
Trash can.
Where's my West Coast people? Where is their recycling? My granola is, where you at? Okay. So, what I want is I want you to have a digital highway, a pathway to success, but that requires us to market responsibly. Unfortunately, you guys are technical experts at something that requires you to retain a mass amount of information in your head that's always changing as well. And to add something new, the idea is, I just want to pay you and leave it alone. I get that, because this stuff makes my head hurt too. I have kids that are much smarter than me. We have one in the room. Okay? You have to participate. Your agency can't care more about your business than you do. They won't. You have tribal knowledge in your head. You have to have something that makes you stand out. The term or step one is branding and website. How are you different? What makes you stand out? There's a lot of HVAC companies. What's unique? That has to come across in your messaging. And market responsibly means that I don't just get on every webinar, listen to a tweet, teach me how to tweet, and come back and go, Twitter, that's it, that's the solution. We need to start tweeting. We have a ton of clients that will come and ask that same question, and I'll say, yes, you should be, but not yet. Well, can we sign up for this service? You can, but not yet. Why? Because you have predecessors, things that have to be in place first, or you're gonna be burning through money I don't want you to spend as an investor in your business. An entrepreneur seeking freedom, time, and money. Which means you have to be an investor in the right things. I think I already said this, but say it again. What do you wanna sell? You have to be careful with this question because you're a subject matter expert. Same thing with me. I start shooting out all these acronyms, you're like, whatever. No clue what you just said. Same thing with you. What do you want to sell? How does the consumer think about it? So when you build a website and it says heating and cooling, you guys are the only people that search for cooling or think cooling is a term a consumer use. Consumer will never search for cooling repair. They will not search for cooling installation. But they will search for air conditioner installation, air conditioner replacement, air conditioner service, air conditioner maintenance, air conditioner tune-up, air conditioner cost, air conditioner financing, AC installation, AC service, AC maintenance, AC tune-up. They will search for that. On the heating side, it depends where they were born and raised. And it depends what state you're in. If you're sitting in New Jersey, they're gonna look for what? Furnace installation. If you're born and raised in Washington State, Seattle, what are they gonna look for? Heater installation. A furnace is something in Freddy Krueger's basement. Those are scary. People don't really have those. They will never say the word furnace. That is a giant thing with teeth and fire. Okay? So, you have to be very careful. Now, a lot of times you guys wind up working with marketing agencies that don't know HVAC or don't know SEO, or they can build a website, but they don't know how it interacts and affects everything else. Everything on this 12-step roadmap is interconnected and interdependent. If one item is off, it's going to negatively impact everything else. One item. I had a gentleman come up to me yesterday and he said, the reviews thing, man, I know this is it. He said, my business, my sales go up and down with my reviews. When my review score drops on Google to 3.5 or below, my sales go down. If I get it back up to 4.5, my sales go back up. Everything is connected. So, where do you sell it? If you talk to an old school advertising company, mailers, flyers, door hangers, all your traditional stuff, they are going to tell you you need to do a demographic analysis by zip code for mail. How many of you have ever put in Google a zip code for your search? Not one. People search either with the term near me, nearby, or the city they live in, or for commercial, the city their office is in. So what do you want to sell? AC installation. Where do you want to sell it? In the city your office is in. Your office first. You can...
I'm sure I understand.
Be quiet, Siri. We'll talk about that here soon. Okay? You cannot go after what you want to sell or where you want to sell until you've proven to Google you own and occupy the city where your office is. So if you have an office in a commercial area, industrial area, there's not a lot of residential, and you sell residential, unfortunately, tough. You have to maximize and optimize your rankings, your positioning, your brand in the city. You have a physical address in for your business first. Then Google will give you some credence in some other areas. Then you can play the other area game and start going after other cities. The challenge is, I hear people say all the time, they're like, I don't rank for anything. Or I rank on Google for, I'm always on page one of Google. So my question is, for what? For what? Because every time you put in a search query in Google, have you guys ever seen Bruce Almighty, the movie? Okay, so God's standing in this warehouse, there's a filing system, guy comes in, he's like, everything you've ever said, everything you've ever done, everything you've ever thought is in this drawer. Drawer flies across the entire warehouse. Every time you go to Google and you do a search, a drawer flies across the warehouse with a specific number of pieces of paper, pages, not websites, pages in it. So when we get to the SEO section, I'm going to go into and show you, you need to be in the drawer, single drawer, for a single service and city, and you need to get to the top 10 so that you are an option when and where consumers are looking for what they're looking for, not generalities like HVAC company, because that's not what they're looking for. And when they get there, you need to look good. That website can do everything for you. It can sell for you. In fact, if you throw some video on it, it can be you. You guys ever woke up and said, I wish I could clone myself for your business? That'll create freedom. I can clone myself. Look in the back of the room right there where Mike is. What am I doing right now? What am I doing? I'm cloning myself. Why? Because this video, it can slice it and dice it into 10 different sections, 10 minutes a piece, or 20 different sections, 3 minutes a piece, drop it on YouTube, tag it for what I want people to find it for, and my hour I spend in this room today will make me money how many years from now? Forever. Okay. Good job. Everything starts with your website. This should be the reflection of you. Now here's the reality. Personality styles are a little different. So first, when it comes to building a website, if you hire Bob to build your site, just Bob, he can't. Because mothers don't give birth to the personality styles it requires to build a website. Does anyone know an engineer? What is their personality style like?
Dry.
Do they guess? Personal preference? What are they looking at? The data. Do they move fast?
No.
Why? Because they're doing what?
Analyzing.
Researching. Analyzing. Do you know a designer? You know a designer, a graphics designer, any kind of designer. They might have went to art school. What are they like?
Creative.
Free spirit. Their house looks nice. They have real friends. Unfortunately. Anyone know a developer? A coder? Anyone know one? What are they like?
Nerd.
What are they like? They're what?
Nerdy.
Nerdy. Slightly recluse.
Yeah.
The garage is a living space. Office hours are like bats. Work at night. Heineken and a Red Bull and some flip-flops will work. Okay. And they can't spell because they write in code. And they can't design because to them, when they look at that screen with all that green code on it, they actually, like the Matrix, see a real world. That's it. They write in code. Content writers, totally different people. Social media, social media. I need you to be my friend. Please be my friend. I have a lot of friends. Everybody likes me. Okay, so social media people. Every single one of the roles in our company, their personalities are entirely different, and it doesn't come in a single human. You can't do it, okay? When it comes to your site, A, don't get stuck in perfection. By the time you have a perfect website, it's going to change. You're going to need a new one. My business coach is Tony Jarrett. He's a coach to the top 500 CEOs in the world, and he is adamant about production before production. Your production before perfection. Get it out. Get it done. Get it working. Start moving. Start making money. Tweak it. Tweak it. Tweak it. Keep at it. Tweak it. Business owners' philosophy or habits are, I buy a website like it's a chair, and it's just going to sit there. Every once in a while, I might throw a pillow on it. But it can't be that, because technically your website can be you. Do you guys believe you're the best salespeople in your company? Heck yeah. So why not take everything that's in here, all your experience, all your history, all the little phrases and stories and the things that you have in you that is what closes the most amount of clients, and make it available to anyone and everyone, including your salespeople who might not be as good. Why not? If you want more time, money, and freedom, but it's exhausting to say, oh, I don't have time for that. For the mere fact that we make the excuse we don't have enough time, means we need to make the time to invest in the duplication, the cloning of yourself, and get it into a space where somebody at the middle of the night can find you. You can sell them online without being there. Technically, you can be in Tahiti with an umbrella, a fishing pole, a jug of beer, a lady, and your naked butt. And it's still working. And you can. So, here's the deal with websites. Anybody remember, it was called Mobilegeddon. 2015, Google came out and said all websites have to be responsive, mobile responsive. And if it's not mobile responsive by this date, we're going to penalize you and move you backwards. You remember? Okay. I'm not going to call anyone out on this, but we warn our dealers. Warn. You got to meet these requirements. You need a new website. Your website might have went live 6 months ago. But when this requirement comes out and it's a new standard of coding a site and designing a site and laying out the content,
if you don't move, all the investments you have in SEO are going to be lost, and it can happen in a day. So all of those company owners that chose to sit on the fence and see if it really happened. The beauty is, all of the guys that said, I'm in, let's get it done, got to go own and occupy a page one, number one spot, when and where consumer search, because the guys that had been sitting there decided to not do anything. That was 2015. The guys that didn't move, their responses to me were, it felt like someone cut my phone lines on Monday. When Google does that switch and it says, everyone that's not compliant is getting penalized, boom, you're gone, off the page. Move down to where no one finds you. Right now, 2017 and 18, Google came out with a new requirement, a new structure for coding sites, and it's called the Mobile First Initiative. So on one hand, if you take the glass half empty route, you're like, oh my God, I gotta get another website. On the other hand, there is gonna be a huge opportunity to take over being the option for those people looking for what you sell in the cities you sell it because of the number of dealers who are going to do nothing. So you do have a wild opportunity, and it only happens that big of a change where you actually have to demolish your site and start over. That only happens about every 2 years right now, 18 months to 2 years. I look at it as huge opportunity. So that's step one. When it comes to designing your site, whether you're looking at it on a computer or tablet or a phone, there's basics. Who you are, without scrolling. Don't want to make someone have to go hunt in the footer on an interior page. Who you are, what you do, i.e. sell. Remember, one page per service and location. Where do you sell it? That's your location. How do you reach you? And what do people think of you? So let's talk about this, how to reach you. These are also called call to actions. For you guys, when you get to take care of your honey to-do list at your own house as dad or mom, when you get to take care of the personal tasks around your house? Evenings? When?
Weekend.
When the kids go to bed. Late? Weekends? How many of you have a website that says you're open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5? So there's... Also, light bulbs help. It's little things. So you don't need to be open to do business, go on jobs for emergency service 24 hours a day. I'm not asking everyone to do that. But your website needs to be open for people to schedule an appointment to talk to you about whatever they need so that they can check that little ping pong ball off their list in the middle of the night when they're bouncing around, ladies. Okay? When they're bouncing around, and they can go to sleep. Because you're one of many tasks, and it's not a fun task. New outdoor barbecue, air conditioning, trip to Hawaii, new heating and air conditioning system. You know what I mean? So A, people aren't shopping when you're open. You can't, as a person, as a human, you can't do it. And B, it's not a fun thing to do anyway. So by having a scheduling system on your site that allows someone to book an appointment, no different than calling, just let them get it off their list. I'm not talking about dispatching. That's the operational side of the business. I'm just talking about a normal human having a lunch break at noon or a break at 10 with no meetings that they can talk to you, being able to go to your calendar, choose an available time, it matches with theirs, you'll call them at 10. They get to check it off their list. They're not gonna go fill out anybody else's web forms. If you have a scheduling system, you're going to be the sole person that they schedule an appointment with and move through the process with. Then it's up to you whether they continue to search for other options. You get the opportunity. If you have a contact us form, they're going to fill out 3 to 4 of those. And you're going to be in competition like this. Make sense? Okay. So, step number 2, words are currency. That means money. text on your website. So Google is deaf and blind. It reads Braille. Can't see your pictures, it's not gonna guess. If you have a website that says ABC HVAC company serving Northern Alabama, did consumers search for local services using the words Northern Alabama? Google is going to file your website in HVAC company in Northern Alabama where no one is looking. Does that make sense? Starting to click? Okay. Content is your ability to speak. If you stop talking, you stop selling. If you never put the content on your website, you're never selling in the first place. Every single page you have with 500 to 1500 words on it, focused on one single topic that Google can file, when it's popular enough to get to the front of Google, you now have a cash machine. Why? Because when people need something, they search where? Google. And you need to be where in order to be an option?
Top 10.
And if they have the ability to schedule with you any time of the day, weekend, evening, or night, you now have a new lead, a new opportunity. And you're not in direct competition because it came through a lead system, pay-per-lead, pay-per-click. It was a real consumer who just wanted to get this task complete. You had a reputable company. I could find you online. Your reviews look good. And I could schedule with you at 2 in the morning to talk to you tomorrow at 10. Simple. Make sense?
Content, people ask me all the time, how much content should I have? Well, let's put it like this. If pages of content equal cash machines, when they become popular, how many pages should you have? Okay, good.
So it's forever. Because the way people research, it depends on where that consumer is in the buying process. If you have somebody that's shopping for a new house and they're looking at older homes, they're gonna have different questions. If you have somebody that's ready to close on house right now and the inspector comes back and the inspector says, this HVAC system's old, you need to get an inspection. Guess what the consumer is gonna look for? Air conditioner inspection in blank. Why? Because their inspector told them to. You have to think down to the nth degree, okay? New high-efficiency air conditioner system financing in blank. I want a new high-efficiency system. I want to know if I can get some financing for it. They're going to look for it. Air conditioning system cost in blank. They're going to want to know pricing. So your list of the content you can have to make you an option in front of those consumers that are looking, it's unlimited. Unlimited. That's why your website can't be a chair. It can't sit there where you just throw a pillow on it every once in a while. It needs to be you. It needs to work for you 24 hours a day so you can go on what?
Vacation.
Yes, sir. Scheduling system is simple. You'll see it on every one of our sites. You're just asking them to schedule a 15-minute phone call, and they can schedule it anytime they want. Okay? If you want to look at that system, you can go to hvacscheduler.com. And it's right there. And all the stuff is on there. Those are samples of the types of appointments. You want to lead people to something specific. So a lot of times they'll just put up a contact form. No, we're not leading anybody anywhere. Are you a current client? You want to schedule maintenance? Are you a new client? You want to get an estimate? You want to get an online estimate? Do you want to apply for financing? Do you want to sign up for our maintenance program? And so forth. How many of you have a maintenance program? How many of you have recurring credit cards on subscriptions? Monthly subscriptions available. Can they sign up on your website? Working on it? All right, I got three. What is a monthly subscription for an entrepreneur? What kind of cash?
Cash flow.
Cash flow, recurring revenue. Heck yeah, absolutely. Every entrepreneur needs and wants recurring income. Create the connection with your client. When our clients come to our dealer sites, they have an account. Why? Because they previously scheduled the time to talk.
They can see all the conversations, the last appointment, the last time they had a maintenance. They can see documents. They can share documents. You can upload their files, their quote, their proposal, their warranty, all their stuff. If you put all of your paperwork on your website so your clients have to come back to your website, if you walked in and said, I got two options for you. We have an online portal. You were already in there, where you can access your warranty, the proposals, all the information on your new system and your maintenance agreement, or I can bring you a printed package when we come out. Which would you prefer? What do you think they're going to say? Online. No one likes paper anymore. And if they have that, guess what you have? A client for life. Because they're actually going to bookmark your website because it has something useful on it. And it's hard to get an HVAC. It's hard to get an HVAC website to get bookmarked. Very hard. All right. So, infrastructure. Step one was branding, website. Step two is content. Words are what? Currency, cash. Step three is online scheduling and a database. So you're collecting every lead, every opportunity. You can remarket to them later. Say you did 10 quotes and they chose someone else. You can still remarket to them and say, hey, would you like me to do a post-installation inspection? We often find things other companies miss and sell them into your recurring maintenance plan. So now we're going to go into step four, which is the marketing piece. Once you have the infrastructure in place, which is a living object, not a chair, then we have the ability to make it popular. All the other things. When I'm going through this, I'm thinking as an entrepreneur and an investor, which means I want to invest in things that have permanent compounding results on my business, not simple interest. What's the difference between something that has compounding results? It grows. The dollar I spend today is worth more. Okay? If I pay for a TV ad, is it temporary or permanent? Simple or compounding? What is it? Temporary. Why? When I'm done spending, I have what? Nada. If I create a YouTube video out of this video and I throw it on YouTube, temporary or permanent? Simple or compounding? Absolutely. If I send out a mailer, temporary or permanent? If I create a content page of content on the website, which one? Permanent. Get my drift? Okay. If I send out handwritten thank you notes, which are awesome to do, temporary or permanent? Temporary. If I create a video that says, hi, I'm Jennifer Bagley with ABC Heating and Air Conditioning, and I want to personally thank you for choosing our company to help you and your family. If you know someone who's interested in heating or air conditioning and you could use their service or they could use our service, we'd greatly appreciate your referral. By the way, please stop by our website, drop us a review. We'll be happy to give you a $25 credit towards your next service. In a video on YouTube sent to every client you do business with. Temporary or permanent? Permanent. Cost me one time, I can use it forever. And I'm accomplishing a heck of a lot more than one thank you note. Make sense? Right on. All right. When it comes to marketing, I'm actually going to fly through this relatively quick because I believe I have 5 minutes. 5 minutes. So let me go back here. Step four is local directories. Okay, that is down and dirty. You have to do it. There are 60 to 70 local listing sites. The expert for them is right there. If you go sit with her, she'll show you the directories. She's young and smart, so if you need to sign a waiver because you get offended, sign it.
All of our kids.
Nice. So, local listings, the way all these directories, this is MapQuest, Google, Yellow Pages, Bing, all of these directory systems, which show up on page one of Google, the way they get you to sign up for their subscription is they put incorrect information on there, number one. Number two, if you don't own the listing, has a little link that says claim this listing, your competitor can take it, put their phone number on it, your company name, their phone number, your address, and happily answer your calls all day. 9 out of 10 that we look at have that exact situation going on and never knew, even if they were paying a local marketing company to manage it. Ouch. Independently of a website, forget about this. This can independently make you money.
Kim will show you the analytics. I think I looked at, for 131 dealers in a particular region, I just pulled it up, in the last 12 weeks, we've made 9,380 something calls and 14,000 clicks to their websites. Up? Okay. Well, go look at her. She'll actually pull the reports up and you can look at them. That is an independent moneymaker, but it's also, it's a risk if you don't take care of it. If you go to all 60 of those, you'll spend tens of thousands of dollars. For a couple $100, we'll take care of all of them. Okay? You have to own the subscription, so it's a monthly fee, but it's worth it if your phone is ringing. You're an investor, things that are going to be cash machines. Reviews and reputation. That's a killer and a must. If you are waiting or hinting around or trying to incentivize your guys to get you a review somewhere with $50, it's going to be hard if you don't have a piece of technology, a software to do it, and if you're sending the reviews to the wrong place. This is complicated. Every review and where it's located has a different strategic impact on the business. You guys see the reviews on Google, right? On the map. That's criteria number one. Most important, in order to get those up, you got to have an app on your phone. Every time you go to a job, you do your work, you ask them how it was, show them how to program the thermostat, ask them if they're happy. They say no, whoop, different process. They say yes. Would you mind if I send you a text message real quick and just leave us a quick love note? Lady in the office goes nuts if I don't come back with one. Jeez. And they're standing there next to their phone. You send it. Boom. You're hovering over their shoulder, staring in their retina and their soul. You click that, that, that. Boom. Reviews are coming in. Checking on every job site. Those reviews then become your content on your website by the city you did the service. Free content by service. By city, customer-driven content for reviews. Reviews are actually helping you get placed in other cities, making you more money instead of just being a review. If you're getting all your reviews on review sites that are membership systems, Angie's List, Home Advisor, make them public. Get them on your website. So priority number one, Google Business Listing. Number two is on your site. Social media. If somebody goes to your social media accounts and it looks unprofessional, or the last time you posted was 2014, what do they think your business is?
Out of business.
Closed. Okay? My opinion of this is, for now, there's 12 steps and 12 stages. Do a Keep You Alive program. Okay? Where you have professional branded sites, you have content being posted at least once a week. Mm-hmm. It's current, it's professional. And then we can come back and get more strategic about how to use that to make money later. For now, you don't want it to lose you business. You don't want it to do that. If you successfully accomplish 1 through 6, congratulations, you're 75% on your way to already doing SEO. If you didn't do these things and you try to do SEO, good luck. Because the functions of SEO by themselves, 25% of the total, without those things, will not work. That's when you'll go, my website company, it doesn't work. Okay. This is your number one priority first. This is your personal brand. When somebody looks for your company name, it's a referral. That's your bread and butter. Those are your babies. Every one of you, go sit with Kim, go sit with Jamal, go sit with Kathy, go sit with Mike, and search your company name and see what comes up. What I want to see is, I want to see that you own your Google Business Listing, which is step 4, and then it's recommending that you add some content and photos. I want to see your Google Business Listing here, and I want to see the stars. I want to see your website first, and I want it to take up a lot of space. I don't want Yelp with a whole nother directory of dealers sitting there. Then I want your local listings, your social media accounts, to take up the rest of the room. Protect your referrals first. That is your number one priority first. That's step 1 through 5. When you're ready to ratchet up a notch, getting into page 1 of Google, page 1 listing, SEO, that's next. Your local directories, your Google Business Listing, your Google Ads, and your Google Home Service. This is way step 11. So if you're doing pay-per-click,
paper call, paper ad, and you don't have the fundamentals in place, you are burning and churning cash, which is why you're always spending and always busy. Temporary, simple interest, you're always going to spend, and if you stop spending, you have what? Nothing. Versus permanent. Make it work for you. What we're looking for, what a man wants to see, every year you move forward. Progress, progress, progress. If you can take one vacation, we've made progress. Two vacations, we've made progress. Three vacations, we've made progress. If your profit margin is growing, if your time is freed up to be more strategic, working on the business instead of in the business, you're going to get the very thing you wanted from day one, which is more what? First one. Time. Second. Money. Next. Say it loud and proud.
Freedom!
Okay. I want you to have that. Is this helpful?
Yes.
Okay. So, you guys, a couple things. There's a card here. If you have a business card, you need a card. If you want, and I do a lot of these, so to prioritize them, if it's 911, write 911. Fill this out. Make sure your email, phone number, website is on there. Our analyst will go through and do a complete digital evaluation for you online. To give you a snapshot of what other people see and what we see. We do this for our existing customers. Every report has stuff wrong. Why? Because you're never done. There is no one that's perfect. Stuff we do, it's got stuff wrong. Stuff that's not done yet. Okay, fill these out. We'll do the digital evaluation. Our sales team is amazing. They're a bunch of analysts and they're personable. They're not pushy, but they will help you customize a plan. Just to give you a quick snapshot of the reality in case you think this is too expensive. Let me go. One second. Anyone can do this right. Absolutely anyone. These are specific programs we have set up for a man. If it was any other company, it would be significantly more. Everything from getting into a framed website where it's kind of a DIY, we do the home page and the first page, we teach you how to add the interior content, that's a bootstrap version. $500, $50 a month. Maintenance support, and it moves all the way up to full-blown e-commerce systems where you want to feature products, you want to have subscription system for your maintenance agreements, you want to be able to sell filters, whatever you want to do, and it goes anywhere in between. Anything can be customized based on where you are. Nothing's ever done. Start somewhere and then keep adding. And let's get to take 3 weeks vacation, make it your goal within the next how many years? Say it.
1 month.
One. All right, you guys. Thank you so much. Thank appreciate you. Handing it to the ladies and Michael. Want to go on vacation again? Yeah, I'll take it.
I put the business card so you can look at it.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you so much. Thank you. You nod and participate. I love it.
Hi. I actually am a distributor.
Yes, I know you.
Oh, great, fantastic. I just wanted to tell you, on one of your marketing slides, you had a typo.
No.
I also want to get on the marketing strategy on your simple interest one. On the actual presentation.
Let me say. Thank you.
That stuff kills me, so I know you're going to be doing this all day.
And I am the worst, because I probably do 6,000 presentations between all the distributors.
Yeah,
and
right. Well, don't worry. I saw it out there.
You're awesome.
Thank
you. If you ever want us to come out.
Well, that's what I need to figure out exactly. I'm kind of new in this role at this company. I've done this for a carrier and for Lennox.
Okay, so let me help you with Johnstone. So hey, we go out to the Johnstones. We'll do a full-day workshop, two-day workshop for the dealers. We have conversion programs. So if you want to invest in, use it as a recruiting program to recruit new dealers.
Yeah.
We already have that built.
Yep.
Same thing with awards for new dealers for fair performance. If you want to incentivize them by making them commit to a certain sales volume and bring them to get XYZ.
Right.
You don't even have to.
But, okay, so my other question is, okay, this is fantastic, and looking at their websites, we know they're shitty. What do we do about it? So identifying it is one thing, actually helping them to keep up with it.
We do all of it.
Okay.
Everything on that 12 step.
That's what I need to know.
With our eyes closed.
Correct.
Yeah.
All right.
So Kathy Marshall books all of my events.
Yeah.
Like I said, we travel. What area are you in?
I'm Florida.
Florida.
So we have all of
Florida.
Okay,
I'm not going there right now.
No, Florida's fine. We're in South Carolina. You don't want to go there.
No.
We shut down an hour ago.
So make sure and connect with Kathy. She can schedule anything if Mike and actually Mike and I, we already have Mike, when are we going to Florida? December? December. We'll be there in December. We just found out that in Fort Lauderdale you can get on a ferry and go to the Bahamas.
Oh, okay.
That's cool.
How are you?
Hi, John Beck.
Johnson Squad.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Florida.
We have Florida.
Hello, sir.
Awesome. Very good.
Hi.
Do you have a card?
I do not.
Can you fill out this?
I cannot.
Okay.
But do you, I'm supposed to get contact with you, so do you have a card?
I do, but I'll have to get your contact information. John Beck.
I just graduated with my degree in marketing.
John Beck at Johnstone.
I don't have a pen. Can
the guy that we had
the first website. Yeah, I'm sorry.
I'll give you. Is this
my
card?
I'm
sorry.
Is this one?
But I wasn't happy with it.
I'm assuming I can find you on the website.
Yes, sir, I can. But I want to take your shirt and that way we follow up. This week we actually
We're doing really well.
So and I've got your email. It's
going to
be
Tell me what you think of this. I don't know if you saw it as just an example.
Yeah.
On the tablet.
Just do that. I don't have my.
No, that's perfect.
Okay, it's way better than what we got.
Okay.
The complicated thing that we have right now is that we are also in the fireplace industry.
Oh, that's easy.
Watch. So it's like, do we have two websites?
No.
Or do we?
Here, I'll show you. Anything you all your scenarios look great. Oh, okay. Yeah. So you can look either way.
Okay.
So, Barron's. New construction. Indoor air quality. We do. Fireplaces, heat pumps, furnaces, hearths, hot tubs, everything. You can do it all from the same thing.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're going to double all your expenses.
Right.
All
which
your
is
expenses.
Which is what the current company we're trying. So we went with AIM Digital,
okay.
And who owns our newspaper.
Yep.
And
that's the first
thing. They hired, of course, basically all they are is a general contractor.
Yeah.
Because they hired it out, and then I was so unhappy with what the guy, they basically copy and pasted our website on WordPress into a different theme. And I was like,
and the theme could be 4 years old and already out of compliance, and they bought a $30 theme.
We're not paying the amount of money that we're paying to have you copy and paste stuff. Like, I wanted a new website. That's not, because I wasn't happy with the old one.
Yeah.
And so now they fired those people. They didn't even have content creators. It was just, and so I'm like, who's doing all this? So now they've hired some other people, and I told them that we've already paid for half of it. And I told them that we may just cut ties, and they can keep their money, and I don't want what they've got.
Because the cost of doing it wrong is way worse than that.
Yeah. So, my dad filled out a card and gave it to them, but I think we're pretty interested in seeing what you guys have
done. How many pages of content do you have? emails?
Mm-hmm. A lot. Yeah. Because right now we've...
What's her website address?
AdvantageHeatingAndAir.com. And one of the reasons why... Oh, really?
Did I spell advantage heating?
Oh, there it is.
That's right.
So...
And it's not secure. Okay. And it's not set up on the server, right? So, like, if our server guys don't put it on the server on a secure server, HTTPS, if our domain people don't put it up with www, penalty, if the site loads slow, penalty, everybody, like, if our web developers do something wrong, it's going to screw up what the SEO people are doing. If our designers make some fancy design that's not mobile first, it's going to screw up the developers' work. Like, everybody has to be perfect experts.
I'm not happy with that. The fireplace. So
this schedule an appointment goes to get a quote.
Right. We don't actually have, and which is what I wanted.
So the only things you sell, I mean the things that make the majority of your money, there's not one product.
Yeah, when you said...
Like the words preventative maintenance, if you Google it, it's going to show you automotive. That's how Google sees it. It's not going to read into it any further. Preventative maintenance page.
And that's where the company that's working on it right now, I don't feel like they don't know anything about the heating and cooling system or the industry at all. Like, just it's...
Yeah, that's not going to work. I mean, the first 2 years we got into HVAC, it took me, like... Beating my people to learn HVAC, the difference between ductless and ducted. I mean, everything.
And I told him, like, I wanted to make sure our SEO was up to date and good. And he was like, well, your SEO is already good. We don't need to touch that.
Okay, well, first thing on an SEO being good is the fact that your site's not secure, so SEO doesn't matter, doesn't count, because there's a big fat thing here that it says not secure. As soon as you get to the site and it says don't go to this site, that's Google's first indication it's going to be pissed. So, here.
Yeah.
Right.
The good thing that we have going for us is we're in a small town, kind of, and it's a growing town, but our competition is way behind.
Okay.
So, even where we're at and we're lacking, we're still. But there are some new companies that are.
I didn't spell that right. So, if you're in a small town, well, this doesn't look like it because there's 3 million pages in here, but this is the beauty. Once you get ranked, this is our client, folks. I want to move the competition out of the way.
Right.
So they own page one, position one, two, three, four, we'll see, five.
Yeah.
Then I put my set here to kick the next one off. And you don't get somebody until the bottom the last three listings. Like, then, small towns, it's not just about getting ranked, it's about getting ranked and being the only option.
Right. So my other thing, too, and I'm sure you guys have had some complaints, this new Google services, Google local services.
Step 11, yep.
I'm mad because we worked really hard to get our ranking up there, and I don't believe in paying for Google AdWords unless we're running a promotion.
Yeah.
And I just want people to click on
just
it.
Just for a minute.
Just for a promotion.
Yep, completely agree.
But then they added Google Local Services, so now there's a company that's not even no one's paying for it in our market.
Yeah.
So they're getting the advertising for free.
Yeah.
And we're the number one company in our market, but we're not up there.
So the gentleman on our team who knows all about that, his name is Mandeep. He's from India. He lives in New York. Coolest cat on the planet. He's a Sikh. Kim is on his team.
if you sit down with Kim and she'll put you on the phone with him and tell him, this is my scenario, what's the deal? He knows it inside and out.
Yeah, because I've called Google and I said, I want to know why it is that a competitor of ours is, who has less reviews than us, who isn't ranked anywhere near us,
is it time
is being advertised.
Yes. What'd they say?
Up at the top of the page. Well, as soon as you get Google Local Services certified,
yeah,
and start paying to be at there, that'll kick them off.
Yeah. Because there's no one paying in that area.
I want them kicked off right now. Because I want them, why I said I want the same free advertising that they're getting.
Yeah.
Well, no, that's not it. It's just random.
Does it rotate? Oh,
they said
random?
It just randomly picks people. And they said, well, you can randomly kick them off. Can't do it. But,
God, when Google Local first came out, I don't know, did you see when it first came out and it actually replaced the Google Maps, looked just like Google Maps, but everyone who earned, I was standing in a presentation on day one when it launched, and I went and did a search. We're in California, yeah, we were in San Francisco where they did the first launch of it, and I did a search and it was like, what?
What is that? Yeah.
The whole map where everybody had all those organic reviews and their Google Maps listing, they've been posting their Google business account, was gone and replaced, looked identical, but it said Google Guarantee. They got rid of the map. So every one of our clients that had no pay-per-click and no SEO, and they only had the map working for them in the city their office was, literally everything stopped one day.
The girl that I did talk to from Google told me that I was the third person who had called her. This was like right after it launched.
Yeah.
She's like, you're already the third person to call and complain that people are being advertised that they don't feel should be. Yeah. And I'm like, yeah, the company that you're advertising right now is not a Google Guarantee, but it's just up there because you randomly decided. They just started their business a year ago.
No experience.
I said, they're probably getting, he's got one guy that works for him, and his wife answers the phone. So they're probably getting calls left and right now. We can't handle it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. We're definitely interested. I won't.
So I wanted to see if I could pull this for you real quick.
My dad likes to use people that are local.
So I can't download it, stupid thing, it's too slow. Mm-hmm. This is your website. What I did is run an entire export that includes every single page, whether it's an image, text, CSS, JPEGs, or content, and all your titles, your SEO. Your home page of your website is called home. No geotarget. No description. These, duct cleaning, no location, no description. Customer survey, no description. Your metadata, all these descriptions, those, when you look on Google, right here, this chunk, all yours are empty.
Okay.
Where'd it go? There's nothing. There's no SEO there for it. Nothing has a meta description on it. Fireplace specials.
Wow. That's
get inspired. Employment. Coupons. Napoleon Fireplace products. That's going to be tough to compete with. Those are the titles of the pages. No geography. No location.
And the problem I have is our company isn't even, it's Advantage Heating and Air Conditioning. That's not
Which
even
would
any.
Help you for SEO because cooling has no value either.
Right.
There's if they said they optimized the site, that is not true.
And so they haven't currently optimized this site. They told me that they didn't. My SEO didn't need to be touched.
Well, they don't have it.
Because it was already good. And I said, I'm like, I don't think that's true. I don't know a lot
about building
websites. So
there's
like,
no SEO. So all
but
it
I know,
takes
I know enough
is,
about marketing to know.
All it takes is to launch one website with some good SEO, and boom, you're gone. Because there's nothing holding it up except the failure of others.
Right. Good. Well, I guess.
Yeah.
How do
we have your card.
Yeah.
So on there, if you can, have them put 911. Where are you located again?
Columbus, Indiana.
Indiana, is that Clay? Over there? Clay Howard. He's awesome.
Okay.
He's a speaker too. He's in California right now, but he lives in Carolina. North Carolina. He will go through, do an assessment of everything, help you put together a plan. When you work with us, what I'd recommend, which I try to encourage everyone to do, like, get close, connect with us on Facebook.
Yeah.
Communicate with us in normal friend ways, not
right.
like vendor-ish.
That's what I like. You can see my text messages with the guy. So I went to school with the guy that works for this company.
Okay.
He's upset because he's restricted. The company isn't allowing it. And I said the fact that your guys' developers, content writers, not a single person has reached out to me
mm-hmm.
from your company to talk to me about this. I said, how are they building me a website if they don't know who I am?
Oh, yeah.
Or they don't know anything about my business?
Yeah. Before we'll start building a website, your project does not start until you complete onboarding, which is essentially the transfer of everything in your head into our team's environment. You have 4 onboarding forms. You have to fill them out.
Okay.
And it's take your time with them. Everyone wants to rush. You know, don't do that. Take your time getting those forms. They're going to pester you. They're like, our team is like a bunch of personal trainers. So you don't hire a personal trainer to let you stay home every day.
Right.
So they are pesty.
Okay.
They're
that's
irritating.
What I need because I'm busy.
Okay.
Right? And so
some
that's
people
what
are like,
we
they
started
come
this
down.
Process and I run the fireplace division for the most part. That's what I deal with. And then the marketing for the whole company for like, I'll just kind of do things here and
okay.
there and push thing. I trying to get you talked
yeah.
about the Google reviews thing. Like every Monday morning meeting, I'm like, guys,
so
please ask for Google reviews.
The tool for that, the lady that knows more than anybody about it, actually all 3 of them, Jamal, Kathy, Marshall, and Kim, Jamal has it on his phone. It's an app. So
yeah.
go tell him, show me that review thing.
Okay.
And let him show you. They'll show you, well, they're here and you're here if you have time to go sit with them. Sit with Mike and look at websites that we've done to pick out what you like. He oversees the design and development teams. But go sit with them about all the different tools and they can show you. Then you can see them face to face too.
The like we have probably 40, 50 more reviews than anybody in our market and
mm-hmm.
we're 5-star. We're almost to our 100th review.
Woohoo!
Like we've been sitting,
call your mom.
We were at 80 a year and a half ago.
Yeah.
And I just like everybody just stopped asking for them. And my dad was like, oh, I don't want people to write bad ones. I'm like, well, if you ask the right customers
yes.
for a review and you don't ask the bad customers,
yes.
people are more.
You don't ask everybody.
Yeah, you don't ask everybody.
No.
That's why
we
have to be
if
selective.
If you ask, are you happy? And they're like, well, I didn't like, then you're
don't,
like,
yeah.
okay, end of conversation. All right, well, let me get you over to.
Yeah, what can we do to make
yeah,
things
what
better?
Can we do? Exactly. You don't drive them there.
And so we're killing it in reviews, but only because the competition is lacking.
Right. So, but here's the thing you're missing. This would be your next step. So
that's our new number one.
Look right here. So what do I want to sell? Where do I want to sell it? See all these cities?
Mm-hmm.
So go in wherever, Mount Vernon stuff. Go to Lake Stevens. Should just go to the whole thing. But so this is optimized for Lake Stevens, Washington, heating and air conditioning service. Now they're in Washington, so heating's more important.
Right.
If they were in Florida, it would say air conditioning.
Can you do that
service.
For even like little towns? Like, so like around us,
yeah.
we have like
communities
like Nineveh, Indiana,
yeah.
which is like.
Yep.
The only
absolutely.
Reason why I want that area is because there's Princess Lakes is there and it's
yep.
a lot of money.
So here's the difference. When you put them on Google reviews, that's great. However, those are helping you close the business that finds you or already knows you. It's not helping you get new business. So your next strategy is to acquire reviews to get new business. So the client says, I'm not happy with service. Forget asking them for a review. Do a check-in. So your guy says, starting maintenance on a new heater, gas, fireplace in Lake Stevens, Washington. It pins it automatically on the map. The client gives a review. Leaves all the stars, it pins the review on the map. Once we have one review or check-in in any city, we automatically go to your website every month and we add all the new pages and optimize for those cities.
Nice.
Every check, so you don't even need the review. Check-ins work. Reviews are gonna help.
Okay.
Every one of these pages that ranks on page number one of Google is making you money. So we'll see if this one does. I don't know if it does or not. Depends how long the page has been up. So we'll go Lake Stevens, Washington. scroll down, there's the page. Not only does it have this page on page one, because it has schematic markup and the reviews, it's going to stand off the page. These are the only two dealers that have the stars showcased on a Google search. The competition is only between them, regardless of who else is on the page. Make sense?
Makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. Now you have something actually making you new money.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. This next class that I do, I'm going to stay out of the PowerPoint and I'm going to do another version. So we'll send you guys all these videos. So the next class I'm going to do, I'm going to stay strictly on the internet,
mm-hmm.
going through and showing all the different examples, showing the tools and so forth. So that way we'll have kind of an introduction, then we'll have down and dirty into the tools, and then I'll go into reports and analysis.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
I love you, Kathy.
Thanks for coming.
This is Kathy.
Hi.
So when I said nearby now, the review system, she knows it inside and out.
It will just be taken care of you if you go live with your site.
Okay.
If you're comfortable with that and the CRM and all the other tools that you're working with.
Okay.
All
right. Thank you.
Thank you.
He is advanced. Oh, awesome. What's his name?
Clay?
No. The company is Advanced Heating and Air.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, you said he got it in my. Okay.
You're
not sure.
Do
you
have
to
know his name?
Advanced.
No, I don't know his name. I don't know his name.
Oh.
I just know it's.
Advanced. We're going to have to really work on leads tonight.
So have them all come in to the next class as well. Because on the next class, I'm going to do a total different workshop.
Okay, cool. I know you're going to try to get it right to come to all of yours. I think I'll be able to table and maybe give you things to everybody. Well, I'll come.